We will now discuss how to illustrate time series data. Essentially, we discuss three types of data sets: the cross-sectional data, panel data, and the time series data. The time series data is information collected over time about a behavior or a process. For instance, when we collect information on housing prices or unemployment rate for a given month over a longer period of time, that data set essentially is called time series data. We will rely on a different data set this time. We are essentially looking at housing construction data or new housing starts from a period covering January 1963 to May 2014. We will demonstrate how to visualize this data using line charts. In this graphic, you would see that housing starts averaging around 1.5 million, even though it says 1,500, it's actually 1,500 times 1,000. So they average around 1.5 million, then they declined, and then they went up. Housing starts are often considered as leading indicators because they decline before recession, and they usually recover before economic recovery. And you could see that the last economic recession in the US happened around 2007, and you see the housing starts declining from a higher value of 2.4 million units to declining to roughly 600 million units. These are annualized rates. At the same time, if you were to look at housing prices, you could see that the average prices has continued to increase all the way until it hit the recession in 2007-08. There was some decline, and housing prices have since been increasing. On the left, on the y-axis, you would see the average housing price, which is around 200,000, and now it's around 300,000 for corresponding to 2014. This graphic illustrates the fluctuation in unemployment rate, which goes up during recessionary times and declines afterwards. Even though this may be an advanced topic, but what you see here is an autocorrelation function, which is a statistical display of the autocorrelation in the time series data. But I will illustrate how to draw this graphic, but we will keep the discussion for a later date. Lastly, we are looking at two time series depicted simultaneously. In the green, you see the unemployment rate, and the gray colored bars represent housing starts. You would see they are sort of negatively correlated. To illustrate these graphics, we click on Graphs, Chart Builder, click on Reset, and then select Line. And within Line, we click on the first palette or template, drop it, click Date, and drop it at the x-axis, and housing starts on the y-axis, click OK, and the housing starts data is illustrated. You can do the same with housing prices. All you have to do is to replace starts with housing prices, and the chart will be redrawn for housing prices. Notice that there is some autocorrelation or serial correlation between this data set. This implies that the value in 1 month is correlated to the value in the past month, and this association declines with time or over time. To check for autocorrelation, we plot autocorrelation function. Click on Analyze, Forecasting, Autocorrelations. Click on Start, say OK. There will be a tabular output as well as the graphical output. Lastly, I will illustrate how you can draw a graph with two vertical axes. Click on Chart Builder, Reset, Dual Axis, click on the first template, drag it, and put date on the x-axis, starts on the left side y-axis, and unemployment rate on the left side y-axis, and click OK, and here's the graphic. To change the color, I will click here and then pick gray as the color, close the dialog box. On the left side are the housing starts values, depicted as these vertical bars, and on the right side is the unemployment rate, depicted as the green line chart.